When I saw the post on Facebook, I thought about the attitude that people have towards America. I don't know if you get that when you talk to Europeans or South Americans. Sometimes they don't see America as a good country. What do you feel? How do you feel about that as American, if you notice that?
Well, at times I've traveled and some people receive me as an American very nicely, and others have maybe a bias towards me. Sometimes it's because of our country's political policies. Sometimes maybe they had a bad experience with an American. But the majority of people I meet are really happy to interact with me and have had really good experiences with Americans. And I hope people maybe have more of an opportunity to meet and talk to live Americans rather than
movies and TV shows.
Right,
you mean,
right. Some of the learning from the stereotypes they see in movies or TV shows, or just some of the more negative press they may hear in the news. Do you have American friends?
Yeah, sure. I've met a lot of Americans, and they are very nice, most of them. But there is a kind of prejudice against the country, not the people. Because when you meet people, they're very nice and
right,
very friendly, but it's kind of a bias against the country, against our international policy, I think.
What year? When were you living in the United States?
First time I'm entered to the USA in the 2010, September. And then back to Iraq. The last time I was in the USA, I was in Ohio in June.
What were you doing in Ohio?
Actually, I'm permanent resident. I have a green card, so I can't go and back.
And are you calling from Iraq now, or you're living?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're back in Iraq.
My brother lives in the USA.
Ah, okay. What did you miss most about your home country when you were here in the United States?
My friends.
Yes, of course.
Here in Iraq, we have friends and the family culture. In the USA, we have a safe area, the nature, everything is beautiful except the friends, yeah, the friend and family.
Mm. And what about, did you, so you're a dentist in Iraq. When you were in the United States, did you have any opportunities to talk to American dentists or to compare ideas?
Yes. For now I'm working on the, I wanted to be dentist in the USA. So now I'm studying in Iraq. So every time I go to the USA, I do the test. It's called National Board Dental Exam.
And where did you learn English? Your English is very good.
Actually, my study in Iraq, the dental school in Iraq, my study in English. And after I visit the USA, I'm starting to work on my language. I'm begun to listen. I'm listening a lot to the English conversation.
That's good. And you have to learn how to listen to people when you're working in their mouth, right?
Yes.
When they're you know, with cotton in their mouth, and that's a whole different kind of listening skill, right?
Yes, yes.
What's your question?
So you mean about American history?
What about it specifically? I mean, there's over 200 years of history. So do you have a particular question about American history?
So, not exactly, but I have some ideas about the civilization of the Americans.
Well, there's a lot that's happened in a very short time.
Yeah.
Have you studied American history in your university?
Yes, but without details.
Oh,
without details.
Without details. Because just I read it alone here in the book, which Andrew titled the title is "The Industry About an Industry to the USA History."
Well, I know there are a lot. You can find a lot of history resources on the internet. Now we have a series in VOA Learning English called The Making of a Nation. It's an American history series. And if you go to learningenglish.voanews.com and do a search for Making of a Nation in quotation marks on our website, you'll find an entire series explaining week. You'll be able to read and listen every week to a 15-minute program about American history.